Hey everybody, Pastor Tim here with today's Devo. The psalmist wrote in his long chapter 119, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. I have sworn and I will confirm it, that I will keep your righteous ordinances. I am exceedingly afflicted. Revive me, O Lord, according to your word." So the question is, how can you know God's will and how can you get on the right path and stay on it? Well, there's a lot of confusion about this, so here are three guidelines to keep you on the right path, and I'm going to even guarantee these. First, God's will is in His Word. Verse 105 of 119 says, "Your Word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." The Bible lights up your path. It helps you navigate life. When you're uncertain or you're in a really dark place, turn on the light of God's Word. Pick it up. Open it up. Do this every day so you're not just randomly reading, but you're beginning to know where answers are. Keep a list of passages that have given you direction. And the scriptures, they help you see where your feet are standing, and more importantly, where you're headed on the path in front of you. Here's a second guideline. Along with spending regular time in God's Word, you can find more light on His will through godly counsel. Proverbs 12:15 says, "Fools think their own way is right, but the wise listen to others." People often think, "I don't want to ask anyone for the input. I know what I want to do. If I ask someone for advice, they might tell me my plan's a bad idea." The Bible says a foolish person doesn't get counsel from others before they make an important decision. Don't be indecisive or decisive on your own. Seek the wise input of those who are trustworthy. And third, the Spirit of God leads us. Philippians 2:13 says, "For it is God who is at work in you both to will and to work for His good pleasure." A lot of people want the Holy Spirit's guidance, but they don't seek godly counsel or the Bible. Yet these are the tools God uses to guide you. God will not tell you to do something contrary to His word and godly wisdom of others. If you insist on deciding against God's word and wise counsel, well, the results are your fault. These three guidelines together are a powerful decision-making combination. You can say, "I've been in the Word, and I'm getting counsel from wise people and godly people. The Spirit Himself is bearing witness with my spirit." You start with Scripture, you add wise counsel, and rely on God's Spirit, and your testimony will be, "He guides me." When life is hard, you want to know you've sought God's guidance every step of the way. That's what I have for you today. It's Pastor out.